Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do a quick face swap in Photoshop. If you'd like to follow along, I have included a link in the description of this video with all the assets that you need. Now, this lesson is part of my new Photoshop Masterclass, where I have 20 plus projects, each one teaching you a different part of Photoshop, teaching you different techniques, tips, and tricks that you can use to become a master at compositing, retouching, or image manipulation. If you'd like to check that out, I have included a link to it in the description of this video. Otherwise, let's dive into Photoshop. All right, let's go to File, Open, and in our Assets folder, I'm going to reopen the 1971 file. And here, I want to just replace the face, but I also want to show you kind of a cool trick that you can use to do this relatively quickly compared to how long it took us to do the last one. So first, I'm going to make a copy of this layer. We'll call this one Original. And then I'm going to go to File, Place Embedded. And here we're going to grab this Luke Broswell file. And for this, I just want to replace the face. So first, we're going to do the same thing of just lining up the faces. Let's put this on 50% opacity, line up one of the eyes, and then do Command T, hold down Option, bring the anchor point there, and then just drag this down until the eyes line up. Now she has a wider face than he does, so you can see the mouth isn't quite lined up. So let's make this a little bit smaller, try to get that mouth lined up, nose lined up, and I think there we've got almost everything lined up to a relatively good degree. I'm also going to rotate it just a little bit, maybe make it a tiny bit smaller, I think right about there is perfect. Okay, so that's where we want her face. Now here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a lasso and I'm going to make a selection. Make sure the feather is on 0%. I'm going to make a selection just around her face area here. So all this to there. And let's go ahead and add a mask here. And here you can make sure that we have everything we want. So maybe I want to leave this part from the original. Let's go ahead and delete that from our mask. And maybe I want to add this part just to make sure his eyebrow is covered. So we'll add that from this image. Just fill that with white. I don't want this little bit right there. So we'll just cut off that tiny bit right there. We'll do that with black. Okay, so now I want to get this face onto this background. And there is actually a tool in Photoshop that'll allow us to do this with one click. So I'll show you first the basic things that you need in place. So first we need this layer, but it can't be a smart object and it can't have a mask. So what we're going to do here is we're going to first just make a copy of this. I'm going to put it underneath. This is just in case I want to go back to it. And then here I'm going to apply rasterize the layer first and then apply the layer mask. Then the other thing I have to do is I have to replace or delete this content out of my original. So to do that, I'm going to hold down Command, click on this, and if I delete it or minimize, hide that layer, I basically want to delete this out of here. Now, I want to make sure that it's inside just a bit so that this one sits just a few pixels over the whole thing. So to do that, I'm going to go to Select, Modify, Contract. And here I can contract my entire selection by 3 pixels. So I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm just going to hit Delete. And that will delete it. And if I turn off my other layers, you'll see that that part of the layer is now transparent. And that's what you want, because you want Photoshop to know, oh, I'm going to use this information to fill in this transparent area. If this has no transparent area, then this layer will have no idea where to put it. Okay, so this will be face, and this will be body. The name of the layers obviously aren't important. We're gonna take both of them, have both selected, and then we're gonna go to Edit, Auto Blend Layers. And this is where the magic happens. We're gonna go to Stack Images, and then we want Seamless Tones Colors, and then we'll turn this on as well, and then hit OK. And voila, they single click. Photoshop has adjusted all the colors and images in this to align with the background. Now you can see here, because of the difference in shading, it had trouble there and it had trouble there, but we can fix that up manually. So let's take our original background. I'm going to do Command J and put that on top and turn it on. And then I'm going to hold down Option and add a mask. And then with a soft brush, go B for brush, with a soft brush on the mask, I'm going to paint in the original image back into here. Like so. And here you can kind of see the old eyebrow. So here I'm going to use my stamp, or my healing brush stamp. Make sure it's on all layers, and then just hold down Option here and kind of help paint this out like that. And I'm also going to do the same with this little chin here, something like that. And maybe with whatever this is here. And there you go. And you can see with just a few clicks, we got a new face onto this. So great way to do face swaps in photos. Obviously here, I would probably do my same trick to just get some of this texture on top of them. Select that from our layer, put it here, make it black and white. I'm kind of going through this quickly because I already showed you how to do this in the last tutorial, and we're not doing anything different here. Same exact steps. Just put that in front like that. Maybe use this mask. And there you go, our before and our after. So again, that's under Edit, Auto Blend Layers. Just make sure you've got a hole in your bottom layer, and then your top layer fills that hole. Line them up, select both layers, go to Auto Blend Layers, and voila, with one click, Photoshop does a lot of work for you to match both images together. So there you have it. That completes this project. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel, leave a comment, share this video, leave me a like. I do try to respond to everything. And again, this is just one project out of more than 20 in my new Photoshop Masterclass. Check that out. I have included a link in the description for you to check out that whole course. I put a lot of hours into it. I really hope you enjoy it. And here's some other tutorials to check out. I'll see you next time.